So, mudlarking at foreshore with lots of brass and copper material. So, let's start picking up small stuff. And maybe there's something nice in between. If not, there's lots of this kind of material. Well, this one I leave. It's full of rust. And this one doesn't make me happy, but it is brass, so I take it. Brass. Some thingy. Three. Much more, yeah? And of course, we're looking for a nice coin. This can be the top of protection of a gun, a rifle. Maybe it's not. It's okay for me. Lots and lots of small stuff here. Nice area. That's a strange thingy. Copper wire. Probably from the inner works of a switch. That's a nice piece, but there's too much iron involved. I leave it. All kinds of material here. Big glass screw, washer. Yeah, that's lead. Make it copper. Copper. No lipstick though. I see a piece of brass here. Yeah. Fitting. Or a volt. Here underneath. Iron, zinc plate, I guess. Isn't this not a nice area for a nameplate? Machine. Really stuck. Piece of river frosted glass, but it's a very nice piece, like a giant bead. Take it. Brass, copper, sorry. a giant bead. What do you know? This brush,
yeah.
Let. Not even let. Oh, that's nice. I need this one to fix the gutter to my greenhouse. So I'm happy with that. Not all. Stainless steel, but that's what I can use. Some kind of switch. Okay, where are we? Oh yeah. In a moment there must be much more copper work.
And casings like this, destroyed, ready to melt down,
but never done.
Yeah, these fittings I leave. There's too much rubbish inside. A T-piece. Very full of rust. S-hook.
That's lead, of course.
My, my, my.
So much here.
And there is a piece of brass and a buckle from Canadians or the Americans.
Okay, have to stop now and we'll come back with you in a moment. Bye bye.